This video will talk about ARM Cortex-M conditionally executed instructions. In the previous video on conditional branch instructions, we have mentioned that if we add a B before this conditional code, we can obtain conditional branch instructions. For example, BGT is branch if signed greater than, BHI is branch if unsigned greater than. In Thumb 2, these conditional codes can be appended to other instructions. This table shows all different types of add instructions that are conditionally executed. For example, add EQ is executed only if the equivalent condition is satisfied. Add NE is executed only if not equal. Add HS executed only if unsigned greater than or the same. There are a total of 14 conditional codes, as listed in this table. Conditionally executed instructions can reduce the number of branch instructions in assembly program. Let's look at this example. The if-else statement in the C program sets the value of y based on the value of a. If a is less than or equal to 0, the program sets y to negative 1. Otherwise, it sets y to 1. Without using any branch instructions, the assembly program can implement the C program in this way. Assume the value of A is stored in register R0, the value of Y in register R1. In the assembly program, we can compare R0 with 0. The move LE instruction executed only if R0 is less or equal to 0. The move GT executed only if R0 is greater than 0. We cannot use move SLE in the assembly program. The last instruction, move GT, has to be executed based on the results of the first instruction CMP. Therefore, the second instruction, move LE, should not modify the NGCV flags. Let's look at a more complex example. If A is equal to 1, 7, or 11, then Y is set to negative 1. Otherwise, Y is set to 1. In the assembly program, we use three comparison instructions. The second and third comparison instructions are conditionally executed, and they have a conditional code, NE, not equal. They are executed only if the not equal condition is satisfied. Pay attention here, the second CMP will change the NGCV flags if it's executed. If A is 1, those three instructions won't be executed. Since the second and the third CMP instructions are not executed, the NGCV flags remain unchanged after the first instruction is executed. Therefore, the move instructions use the comparison results of the first CMP to test whether they should be executed. More specifically, the move instructions are conditionally executed based on the NGCV flags modified by the first CMP. If A is 7, the comparison result of the first CMP is not equal. Thus, the second CMP will be executed. The third CMP is not executed because comparison result of second CMP is equal. The move instructions are conditionally executed based on the comparison result of the second CMP. In other words, the move instructions are conditionally executed based on NGCV flags modified by the second CMP. If A is 11, the result of the first CMP is not equal, thus the second CMP will be executed. Again, the result of the second CMP is not equal, thus the third CMP will be executed. The move instructions are conditionally executed based on the result of the third CMP, more specifically, the NGCV flags of the third CMP. If A is 100, both the second and third CMP instructions will be executed. The move instructions are conditionally executed after three comparisons. How does the processor use NGCV bit flags in the program status register, PSR, to test whether a condition is satisfied? This table summarizes the answers. For example, The processor checks whether the zero flag is set or clear to test the condition of equal and not equal. If Z is 1, the result of comparison, or we say the result of subtract is 0. Thus, the operands are equal. If Z is 0, the result of subtract is non-zero, thus operands are not equal. To test the condition GE, sign greater than or equal to, the processor checks whether the negative flag N and the overflow flag V are equal. If they are equal, the GE condition is satisfied. Now, let me give you a short explanation why the GE condition checks whether the N flag and the V flag are equal. In this short example, add GE is executed only if the signed integer held in register R0 is greater than or equal to the one held in register R1. The CMP instruction performs the subtraction and updates NGCV flags based on the subtraction results. Since we are comparing two signed integers, we should pay attention to the overflow flag instead of the carry flag. Now let me explain why the result is signed greater than or equal to if overflow flag V equals the negative flag N. When V is 0, it represents that no overflow has taken place in the signed subtraction. If there is no overflow, the result of signed subtract will be correct. Since N is 0, we know that the result of subtract is non-negative. Based on these two observations, we know that the result of R0 minus R1 is greater than or equal to 0. Thus, R0 is signed greater than or equal to R1. Similarly, if N is 1, we know that subtract result is truly negative. Thus, R0 is signed less than R1. On the other hand, if V is 1, an overflow has taken place, indicating the subtract result was incorrect. If N is 0, the N flag mistakenly reports that the result is non-negative. In reality, the result should be negative. Therefore, R0 is signed less than R1. Similarly, if N is 1, the subtract result is mistakenly reported as negative, while it should be non-negative, that R0 is signed greater than or equal to R1. This truth table summarizes the conclusion we have obtained. It shows that R0 is signed greater than or equal to R1 if and only if the overflow flag V and the negative flag N are equal to each other.